there are some lies in our science books. Taught it for 15 years. Even though I'm not teaching it anymore, I still like to study. It's so many neat things to learn. We're going to cover some of that tonight.
Perception is being managed. We are being steered and guided by a hidden hand.
The whole world has been duped by the media that is not real.
Smart thinking, possible time traveler, smart thinking.
That night, boom, contact memory.
And then, Alex, if you don't agree, you'll be sent to a re-education camp.
Just because I'm old doesn't mean I've lost my touch with the natives.
A lot of people here tonight felt like they lost. You know why?
Now, experts are suggesting that we're in a golden age of shape-shifting reptilian sightings. Now, why is that?
I was, and still am, a huge conspiracy guy. I literally ran out of new tin hat topics to research.
It was most definitely not capable of melting steel.
Then I would be a crackpot if I thought that was the case.
Thought that was the case.
Welcome to the Hypothetical Institute, a podcast about conspiracies.
My name is Luke.
I'm Salt.
I'm Cam. Gentlemen, how are we?
Yeah, good, mate.
Yeah, I'm all right, thanks. How are you, mate?
Oh, mate, I'm bloody tip-top. We've got just an easy-peasy one today. Has anyone ever addressed this, that all of the news is conspiracies now?
I don't know. It's a pretty unique take on it all, I think.
Mm. Well, copyright Cam Smith, all of the news is conspiracies, 2024.
I found it really tough to find anything good for this.
Yeah.
Because it's all just, like, normie shit, you know. Oh, look, a Photoshop.
So we're going to talk about Kate Middleton, aka Catherine, Princess Catherine. That threw me when, like, the Photoshop thing came out and she posted her apology and it was signed C. I was like, who is C? Huh. I know K and W. It was all a trick.
Yeah, that caught me out when they said it on the news and stuff. They'd say Princess Catherine. I'm like, I'm not up with my princesses, but why are they talking about this one?
Yeah.
So. Maybe a quick timeline from you, Robbo.
A timeline on all this?
Yeah.
No, I don't have that. You should have maybe checked if I had that.
Princess Kate, a.k.a. apparently Princess Catherine,
mm.
went into hospital a few months ago. She's sort of not been seen much of since.
Mm.
At the time, they're like, you won't be seeing much of Princess Kate because she's been to hospital.
Yeah, and it was just for some sort of abdominal thing, right? She had some sort of surgery.
Yeah. They're like, you're not going to see much of her, so don't worry.
Yeah.
And what did they do? They started worrying.
They offed her, mate.
People are like, we haven't seen much of Kate Middleton lately, which, to be fair, you do often see quite a bit of her.
Yeah.
If you care about that stuff, which I don't, so it didn't make really a huge difference to me. Mm. But it started this sort of, where's Kate? Hashtag, where's Kate? Then finally, what they all wanted was proof of life. She releases a Mother's Day photo on her Instagram. Mm. It's her and her three weird-looking kids. And it's like, there's Kate. Problem solved, except the image had been manipulated.
Oh.
And I think it was the Agence France-Presse, or maybe it was just the regular RP, released a kill notice, which I think, if you don't know, if you're not familiar with the news wires, sounds quite drastic.
Mm.
Kill notice on this photo because it shows signs of manipulation. But you know who was really being manipulated? It was us. Because they wanted us to associate the royal family with AI images. So when all of the images of them taking part in satanic bacchanals come out, they'll be able to say, no, it's just AI. You know how royal images are always AI and manipulated? Anyway, that's one theory.
Mm, I did see that one.
There are some other theories.
That's probably, as all the ones I found, that's probably the most kind of interesting in terms of, I guess, our world of a podcast, because everything else is like he had an affair or she is unhappy and she's going to leave or she's really unwell and that's, you know, they're trying to cover it up.
Yeah. So, yeah, the thing is, this image was like, it was like dodgily photoshopped to the extent that you would think that the royal family, controlling the world's drug trade, taking control of world affairs for hundreds of years, mm-hmm. you'd think they might have someone on hand who could do a better Photoshop job. So when they eventually came out and said, I was just Kate Middleton mucking around on Photoshop, that seems quite plausible to me. But,
yeah, I've heard people sort of say that, she, you know, she wouldn't be doing that herself, but what else is she doing with her day?
Yeah.
Well, she's also just, because she's just had surgery, she's probably kicking around home going, well, I can't go do any public shit. What can I do? Oh, yeah. Let me just get the MacBook.
The thing is, she, if you got a hold of her MacBook Air with the M3 chip and her Photoshop Creative Cloud subscription, like, she would be on Photoshop 2024, Prince William, oh, give him a lizard head. Like, her laptop is full of all of the worst nightmares of David Icke. Yeah. So it was just a bit of dodgy Photoshop. There was lots of like lots of Photoshop experts came out of the woodwork. I feel like Salty, you and me.
Yeah, I had a look at it. It's like,
But like, I saw one article in the Daily Mail where they quoted like five Photoshop experts. One of them, whose nickname is the Photoshop Guy.
Jesus.
It's like, that could be us. Why aren't we on speed dial for answering Photoshop questions?
Because you've got to have a YouTube channel that shows it and call yourself something lame like
the Photoshop guy. Photoshop,
yeah.
There was one guy, his expertise in this article, who's like he's used Photoshop and has used software professionally for over 20 years. Ooh. It's like, that's a lot of people have that qualification.
Yeah. Just generic software?
It was just software.
Right.
So the Photoshop stuff, like, it was clearly someone just doing something bad. Like the edges and stuff. Because I don't know what I'm doing when I do use Photoshop. I'm just kind of mashing buttons till something works for me.
Yeah. Graphics design is your passion, but your passion sometimes overtakes your skill.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so if you're doing the patch tool, and you move something over, and sometimes there's a blend mode that I don't fully understand, and it blends the edges. Mm-hmm. I think that's what that looked like to me. Like, she's tried to, like, you know, get layers of four different photos and then patch them over and just done a bad job.
I did see someone saying, like, you know, if there was, like, snot on the sleeve of this little girl, that would make sense that they've just sort of tried to rub that out. But 'cause there are points where, like, the sleeve has disappeared. One of the things that people were accusing her of was that all of these photos, this photo, it's just one photo, had been taken back in November because there was some other event where they were all wearing the same clothes.
Right.
And I did watch the viral TikTok on this and they're like, well, she's wearing a sweater that has like this, Kate is wearing the same sweater. It's a different color, but it's essentially the same sweater if it was another color. The little girl is wearing like the same shoes and the same top and the same pants. The other children are not wearing really the same clothes, but it's like, it would make sense that they would take a photo that they took back in November and they would just change the colors of the clothes so that, it would, you know, look new. And it's like, why are we doing that?
Well, she had to release something
for Mother's Day.
Yeah. So, you know, it's a generic, oh, aren't we all like, I don't know what the initial caption was, but was the intimation that it was like taken an hour before it was released or?
I don't think there was like it was just a Mother's Day photo, but I don't think there was anything saying taken in the past 24 hours, this is my proof of life. It was because it was being taken by other people as this is a proof of life photo that it took on those dimensions.
Yeah. I guess part of the Photoshop was editing out the newspaper that one of them was holding up with a date in November. I listened to a TMZ podcast about this, and they said that it had been edited 16 times, and they seemed to have thought that was a lot.
Mm.
Like, oh, there was 16 different Photoshop edits that went into that photo. And that doesn't seem like enough to me.
No. Like,
I mean, does that mean 16 actions or does it mean the file was open and resaved 16 times? Because, I mean, opening and saving it 16 times is a fair amount.
I think there were 16 points on the photo where there had been an edit made.
That's what I think it was. And I don't know, it's just a weird way to say it, kind of. I don't know, someone like TMZ is probably really familiar with how things are photoshopped and made to look candid, but still made to look candid. Like, you know, a lot of the paparazzi stuff we see is given to the media by the celebrities themselves, and they're always, like, they'd be retouched in those instances as well. Like, TMZ would know how this goes.
Yeah.
They also played a call of someone ringing up TMZ to talk about it. And they said, all the news they've been seeing in other sources is really tabloidy. And I'm like, do you not know what you're ringing up?
Yeah.
I have to confess that some of the time I should have spent researching Kate Middleton, I did spend just thinking about the Ghislaine Maxwell paparazzi photo.
Yeah, that was way more interesting, wasn't it?
The one at the burger shop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where there were all sorts of things photoshopped in that.
Oh, we dove into that one, didn't we? There was movie posters and all sorts of shit that was like weird about it.
Yeah. That I wanted that giddy high.
Oh, yeah.
Of finding a weird little thing that didn't need to be photoshopped.
But yeah, I didn't get that from this. There were people who were like, "Oh, her face is exactly the same face as on, I think, the cover of Vogue."
From a few years ago. Yeah.
And it's like, well, her face did look quite similar because it's the same face.
Yeah.
Now,
but also when people like, I saw people taking that photo and overlaying it onto the new one and going, look, it's identical. And it's not at all. She's like, clearly looks a little bit older. The lighting's completely different. Like, just because her fucking face shape is the same as her face shape was a few years ago and probably still will be in 10 years. It's like, it's fucking.
She probably practices getting her photo taken.
Yeah.
Like that would, I imagine, a pretty big thing that you'd need to know how you look, and you'd probably find a spot that you just,
this is your best angle.
Now, there was a lot of finger science that went on because people know that AI can't do fingers.
Oh, yeah.
But so one of the kids is especially doing a weird little thing with his fingers. He's like doing little walkies on the table with his
fingers. He's got one of his fingers crossed over, and it's just a dumb thing kids do.
Yeah. I think people are like, I know that AI doesn't do fingers right, and so his fingers look a little weird here, so it must be AI. But it's like, AI does hands in normal positions with more fingers than are necessary. It's not. I don't think you really see that much AI fingers where it's like, I don't know what these fingers are doing. Sometimes you might see one where there's like a finger jutting out of the top of the hand or something, but they're not just like doing weird kid shit.
Yeah, they never hold complete fingers just in a weird position. There's always something cursed about them.
Because it's all, what it's trying to do is approximate what a hand looks like. It's not trying to do any weird stuff.
I tell you what, AI is actually pretty good at hands now.
Yeah. It's come a long way.
that AI thing, that's, I think people are just always going to scream AI a lot of things now.
Mm.
Like, you know, this is just AI, this article's AI, this person, like, it's become shorthand for, I think this is bad, or I think this is, you know, dodgy in some way. Because it definitely didn't look, as Cam, you're saying, it didn't look AI at all.
Well, what looks AI to me, not the fingers, but just the faces and how happy they are.
You don't think they'd be happy?
Well, I know they obviously haven't been reading the newspaper. Now, there's just something about the faces that was a little bit off. And one of the explanations that I saw that makes the most sense is that there's like on these smartphones, I don't know if my Nokia 2200 will do this, but apparently there's like a function where you can take 5 photos and it will like pick out the best faces from each of the photos and sort of paste it all together into one pic.
Yeah, I think that's a thing that's in the camera. Like the camera will take a bunch of rapid photos
and then combine them.
Merge them together, yeah.
Yeah, so everyone's eyes are open.
Yeah.
I could see the queen, whatever her name is, the princess, having like a phone that does something like that.
Yeah.
Now, is she missing out on Snake? Yes.
I think you can download Snake from the App Store, right?
Yeah. Probably. And even if it's not in the App Store, just dust off the old TI-83, right?
Mm. the Samsung cameras, the way they upscale photos now, they changed it as well with one of the last updates, and you can actually go in and turn it completely off now, but they use AI and a few other things to really scale up photos. And man, it's quite bizarre. You take a photo, then you see it change immediately in the camera in the phone. And
is it making them look better?
Sometimes, for sure.
Heaps of sharpening and like stuff like that.
Yeah,
like I've seen you guys some photos from my phone where I've zoomed up on boats that are like on the horizon, and it's insane how fucking decent.
If it's low light inside, it does make it look kind of fake. Like it ups the clarity quite a bit, and the colors get more vivid. So, yeah, I've turned it off. I don't like it. It's just weird. Like you go, oh, that's a nice thing to take a photo of, and then it comes out completely different.
One thing I noticed that no one seems to have commented on is, so this photo is supposed to have been taken in like March.
Mm.
It's during the daytime. In the background, you can see the full moon in perfect clarity.
Really?
No, it's a little Samsung camera.
Belt. Oh, I see what you're doing there.
You see all of the lakes of the moon.
Well, I mean, there was that talk of it being a different month because it's, dead of winter or the end of winter in England, and there's all the trees are green.
Mm.
But again, as I think we said, they didn't make it out like it was a new thing.
Mm. I did notice there were some good headlines I saw out of this. One of them was in news.com.au, and the headline was Prince William Abandons Kate.
Right.
And then it was an opinion piece.
Mm-hmm.
And the start of the opinion piece was like, it was presented as like this feminist thing. The blokes of the royal family are always throwing the women under the bus, which is an improvement on chopping their heads off.
Mm-hmm.
But, I don't know. I felt like the
throwing them down French tunnels.
I felt like the headline "Prince William abandons Kate," not with an opinion on the front of that. So a little bit of clickbait. I don't think that was particularly sisterly in my view. But anyway, who am I to? I'm as stale male and pale as they come over here, so I can't comment. But just didn't seem like the sisterhood was in action fully there.
So one of the big theories that is going around is that she's having he's had an affair,
right,
with what's her name, Rose Hanbury. She's got like four names because I don't know.
They all have too many names.
Yeah, Rose Hanbury. And then you click on a Wikipedia page and it's Sarah Rose. It's spelled, looks like it's Cholmondeley, but it's pronounced Chumley. I don't fucking know why. She's the Marchioness of Chumley. And she's married to David Chumley, the 7th Marquis of Chumley. Mm. I fucking tried to find anything interesting about these guys, and man, they are boring. Like, he is just, well, he's a bit of a creep. So I think they met when she was 19 and he was in his 40s. Mm. They're still married. And so, like, you read his Wikipedia page, and he's like a peer. And he acted as the lord, and then it just lists all these, like rich lord stuff that he does, and all the titles he has, and all the land that he has. And it's like, why are England not just guillotining these fuckers?
Yeah.
Like,
and why are we taking direction from them?
Yeah. What's going on here? Like, can we not? What is happening? It's so bizarre that this kind of incredible old money upper class just has so much power in the UK still, and by default, I guess, Australia and New Zealand. So, yeah, they were apparently friends, and then they had a falling out, and the theory was that he cheated with her, Prince Harry. No, Prince William cheated with Rose.
With the marriage and Ash.
Yeah. I went on to – I'm so desperate to find anything interesting about these people. I went and found her Instagram. She used to be a model. And her Instagram, so they live in this place called Horton Hall, which is her Instagram handle. And so it's all like, it's like a sculpture park there, and they do like art exhibitions there, and they live there. And it's, one of these big fucking stately places. Some legitimately interesting and good art is shown there pretty regularly. But so her Instagram account is both her personal account and like the goings on of the hall. So it's like, you know, look at the sculpture park, you know, look at this great sculpture from so-and-so. And then there's like a photo of her. It's like, oh, here I am. It's like, separate your whole Instagram from your personal Instagram. It's confusing.
Mm.
To be honest, that's all I got out of her. Her Instagram is confusing. Oh, she was a researcher for Tory politician Michael Gove, conservative politician Michael Gove, who was, I think he's one of the ghoulish conservatives in the UK, and so she's probably pretty awful.
Mm. Oh, well, just on the separating your socials, one of the other points made in that stupid article that I mentioned was that, you know, Prince William could have, like, chucked a W on the end of the tweet where Kate Middleton was like, oh, it was all my bad. So they could have been like, oh, it was all our bad.
Oh, like, right.
I think that might have pushed me over into full guillotine mode if they shared like a social account like that. If they were doing like co-signing tweets. These poms, I got to say, I've been looking at some of the things that Britain have done over the years and they haven't come up looking too squeaky clean, to be honest.
Yeah, you're saying the history of British colonialism is maybe not so good?
Yeah. I would say it's time to wrap it up.
Yeah.
So I did find some cooked things.
Mm-hmm.
I thought there's maybe some good psychic gear.
Ooh, what are the psychics saying?
Well, so this one... So
you'd have to go back a few months to see what the psychics are saying about this, though.
Yeah, right. Yeah, set my Google search time window to pre-November. This lady, I don't know down her name. I found her on like Rumble or something. And she was saying, you know, people have been asking me about this on my Patreon. So I went and had a look at the family. It was her quote. It's like, oh, that's creepy. Don't, like, if you're a psychic, don't just go into people's lives. And I don't think I've ever really thought of it like that, but like, don't remote view into people's affairs.
Oh, she's just been bouncing around all the various halls.
I think so, yeah. Just having a little nosy. Anyway, she's said that we don't know this yet, but the royal family were supporting Epstein Island, which involved child trafficking.
Oh, we don't know if there are any connections between the royal family and Epstein Island.
Yeah, yeah. She does, though, say it's not the Andrew thing. It goes much deeper, which, I don't know, that's already pretty damn deep. He was one of the main dudes. She was saying the royals were financing the child trafficking, which doesn't make any sense because Epstein was famously rich.
Mm.
But then she goes on to talk about that people are weak, where they're somehow using – what was it? Well, I can't remember how she got to this. Anyway, she got to talk about the Holocaust.
Oh, God.
And that was all about controlling people and breaking them down so that reptilians could take over.
Mm-hmm.
And I think – oh, that's right. And she kind of knew about this, Catherine, Princess Kate, and she's been – well, she's also had trauma, so she's kind of been like trying to suppress it, and they've been trying to make her forget it. So now it keeps on coming back up, this whole like reptilian thing, and she's now aware of it. So they put her into a coma.
Mm-hmm.
So all this kind of it's triggered her programming. She's been MK Ultra'd, and so it triggered her programming, and she remembered stuff, and she started blabbing. So they dosed her up.
Who was she blabbing to? When did this happen? Well, they managed to catch it before it got out.
Yeah, probably like a butler or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
And Charles doesn't have cancer, but they're just going to like shut everything down until it all blows over.
Oh, yeah.
She also says the relationship with the press, that they give the press money and take them on holidays, but the press is turning on them now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, this is the... interesting in scare quotes here. The interesting thing about this whole thing is it sort of has exposed this weird relationship between the royal family and the press in a way that maybe hadn't been as exposed before. I think people know that there's an antagonistic relationship, but there's also a symbiotic relationship.
Mm.
But there's also, you know, certain media are favoured, but you've had this weird situation present itself with all of the speculation about her, where it would be, from a PR perspective, the thing to do is to come out and say, she's fine.
Mm.
But they're in this, there's this meta battle going on where it would be, it's almost worse for them to like give in to, I think they see it as being driven by the tabloids, but to give in to the conspiracy theorists and admit that they need to say that she's fine because they sort of want to be above it all while still reaping all the benefits of it.
Well, yeah, that's I think that's a point that's sometimes made, is inherently their lives have to be public because of all the land and money they get from that role. You know, they're figurehead, so they need to come under scrutiny, and you just can't disappear for 3 months.
Yeah.
I think you probably can, because, like, nothing changes if they disappear for 3 months.
You could even say if they disappeared forever.
Yeah.
Or if the whole country disappeared.
But they – so she – I mean, sorry, they'd said that she wasn't going to be speaking – or in public before Easter anyway. So it's not even at the point that this is unusual yet. We've got like 3 weeks. I did get sidetracked when I was researching this, and I'll come back. I'll circle back, but I think this was – I came across this – I think it was on BitChute or Brighty in one of the cooked things. A guy called Find the Light, and he in the description of his video about the moon – that has more structures on it than any planet, possibly even Earth. That on the moon, there's woman's equality, woman's head coverings, rebellion, fallen angel, head control, men's pants, cross-dresser, androgynous transgender, kidnap human brothels on the moon. And their children are used for human meat and adrenochrome blood for the fallen angel, vampire, fake alien devils. Yeah.
That'll do it.
I spent a lot of time watching those bits because that was way more interesting. But then I ended up coming back to a video that was Where is Kate Middleton? Timeline of Key Dates. And again, I found this on like Rumble or BitChute or whatever. And I thought it was someone talking over or repurposing a Channel 7 news report to like give some cooked theories. But it was just a Channel 7 news report. if you Google Where is Kate Middleton Timeline of Key Dates, it's 7 News Australia's YouTube, and yeah, indistinguishable from cooker shit. Like maybe a little bit, like the voice recording's a little bit better and the script's a little bit better, like tighter, but yeah, there was really like no difference. And I know we made the joke at the start of the show, but like that was like, oh yeah, that's pretty weird. The only other thing was, according to a royal insider, Kate Middleton was murdered in an Illuminati blood sacrifice.
Oh, those bloody Illuminatis again.
Yeah, and I watched the video and it didn't, I don't know, it wasn't, it was surprisingly no substance.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I guess maybe a final bit of Kate Middleton. Because all of this has been pointless until now. On Reddit, r/conspiracy. An Australian, I believe, user, Eureka Stockade, who posts like 3 times a day with these massive Gematria posts. I just realized they're Australian now. And so long-time listeners know how excited I get when I suddenly realize someone's Australian. 10th of March, Kate Middleton's Photoshopped Mother's Day picture makes world headlines as intended. 10th of March equals 10/3 in the Australian dating system. Princess equals 103 in Gematria. I'm not sure if they are using Jewish or English Gematria. Presumably English if it's Kate Middleton. Go ahead signal equals 103. 11th of March, Princess Kate apologized for photoshopping the picture on the 13th anniversary of the Fukushima nuclear plant accident. Kate Middleton photoshopped equals 119. Kate Middleton Princess of Wales equals 119. Princess Kate apologized equals 119. Monarchy equals 119. Nuclear plant accident equals 119. Or if you want to say nuclear accident equals 133, 133 days later after what? 21 July equals 911. Days after the US State Department ordered diplomats to leave Ukraine on 23rd Jan 2022. 21 July 2024 nuclear power plant disaster equals 666. Say no more.
Oh, shit.
Princess is also code word for invasion. Princess is 103. Invasion is 103. So the go-ahead signal, 103. It's the go-ahead signal for the invasion.
Who's being invaded?
It's not entirely clear. Cyber.
The good thing with Geometra is they'll find out after it's happened.
Yeah.
Oh, this is happening, and they'll punch all the numbers and go, ah, that's happened.
Princess equals 103. Stock market crash equals 103. 23rd April 2024 equals St. George's Day. 6 years, 6 months, and 6 days after George Soros moved $18 billion to his Open Society Foundations on 17 October 2017. I'm not sure what that is, but yeah, there's a lot of dates and things coming up. Keep up the good work, Eureka Stockade.
Yeah, that's good. That's some good effort.
They do like, that was about a quarter of what they wrote, and they do three of those a day.
Jesus.
Right.
Soon they'll have enough to bloody put together some sort of PDF, aka or novel.
Mm-hmm. Should we do some news?
Yeah, just before we...
I'll mess with the button.
Before we do, so this is coming or being recorded on the 17th of March. And apparently there's like going to be an announcement today or tomorrow. So
okay.
I just think she's unwell and, you know, it's just whatever. But if she's secretly dead or in a MKUltra coma and then that all comes out.
You heard it here first.
Yeah. I'm not going to be too embarrassed by getting that one wrong.
All right. Time for some news?
Yeah.
All right. Item number one. I wrote a bloody article.
You what?
I wrote an article for crikey.com.au. And Robbo, you played a very important role in the writing of my article.
Inspiration? A muse?
Yeah, you are my muse. I wrote about those fake videos that you see on Facebook of people getting into arguments with Karens.
I thought you were going to say you wrote it in a very aloof voice.
No. They'll like come and knock on the door and they'll be like, oh, I've noticed you've changed the password on your Wi-Fi. I really need to use it. And the person in the house is like, what do you mean you're using my Wi-Fi? And a little argument. Or there'll be, someone coming and knocking on a window. They're like, what are you doing parked on my street? It's, well, I'm allowed to park where I like. Well, it's a bit weird. You parked on my street. Anyway, the one that I wrote about was a guy's eating a Happy Meal outside of McDonald's. And this woman comes up to him and she's like, what are you doing eating a Happy Meal? You don't have any kids here. And he's like, I'm allowed to eat a Happy Meal. Yeah, it's all I could afford. Yeah, it was true, cost of living crisis, austerity Britain. And there's this whole argument. She brings up like the Epstein flights. It's like sort of suggesting that maybe this is like step one on going to Epstein's Island. And it goes on for about 3 minutes and finally just sort of concludes. And it was the fakest thing I've ever seen. Robbo, what was your take on it?
I started watching it and I didn't think it was fake. I didn't know that it was fake. And then I read some comments. I don't know where I watched it. However you sent it to me, Instagram or Reddit or something. And the comments were like, this is fake. This lady's on lots of videos.
Yeah.
And I went, oh, yeah, I know this is fake too.
Yeah. So.
But like, I'm not familiar with a lot of this content.
Yeah.
Like these kind of angry, you know, kind of revenge filming videos or things, like, I never click on them, so the algorithm doesn't feed them up. I click on like people doing silly little dances and I get mad at them, and then the algorithm keeps on feeding me them. And now I have people around the world who I loathe because they don't like how they dance on the internet.
So I got onto this one because I saw like right wing people on Twitter sharing it, and I was like, it seemed so obviously fake to me, just because I've like spoken to people before, so I know what a human conversation sounds like. But
they were British.
They were British.
Brits,
well,
all bits are up. I've heard some Brits say some pretty wild things. So
yeah. Anyway, I tracked down the woman in the video and had a chat with her, and she explained the whole thing to me, which was just that they film like hundreds of these videos, the company that does them. She was just an actor. So she picked up a job off like a Star Now and filmed 10 of them in a day. And, yeah, they put them up on a Facebook page. They get lots of likes on the page. the page I saw it on had like 500,000 likes, and then they just delete all the videos and sell the page to some brand, and they change the name. And that's why every now and then, if you've liked one of these pages, you'd be like, oh, I'm getting a lot of things coming up in my feed for this page that I don't remember ever liking.
Right.
So, yeah, pretty simple, but, yeah, it was just insane. All of these right-wing people on X.com who some of them are pretty dumb, like that Ian Miles Chong guy, who I think is actually quite stupid.
Mm.
But at the same time, it's like, obviously he knows what he's doing a bit. It was a larger lady in the video, and so the comments are like perfect for getting engagement on Twitter and making a little bit of money off the ads program, because everyone's going to be like, it's, you know, the sort of comebacks write themselves. Mm. It's like, yeah, this, my conclusion was, this is maybe not a great situation just generally. It might be emblematic of something that needs to be looked at by somebody, but.
Well, it's kind of weaponizing. Like, you know, you mentioned that it talks about Epstein, and he also mentions, you know, he's got something from the Happy Meal menu because it's all he can afford. Mm. So it's like cost of living in there. So it's like, it's just touching on any nerve that it possibly can find to get outrage. So yeah, the results of that, just making people angrier at other people on both sides. Like, I think people, and I think that's maybe why I didn't twig that it was fake, is there are people going around, you know, that have just cooked themselves on the internet that are convinced that this, you know, someone having a Happy Meal might be dodgy. So, you know, like, we just kind of, it's just making all that worse. It's just crowbarring more anger into that whole situation.
There was one that I saw that I hadn't seen when I wrote the article, but because there's a bunch of the subgenres of these. There's like, yeah, Karen's coming up to people who are parked. There's, you know, the Wi-Fi neighbor thing. And there's a bunch of them where it's like a landlord is coming around to like ask the tenant to move somewhere for like a week so that their family can stay.
Mm.
And so there's a bunch of those, but I did see one after I'd written the article where this little old woman comes around. She's like, I need you to move out of the house for a few weeks because my family is all coming from Israel. And it's like, oh, not a good look. Not a good look, guys.
Mm. Mm. Don't get tricked online.
Yeah. No.
Watch dance videos that you don't like instead.
Yeah. Anyway, other news. What happened to Kevin Kelly?
What did happen to Kevin Kelly? So let me just refresh, mate. Oh, yeah.
He's removed from the AEW roster.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, there's been a lot of stuff going on in wrestling, and one of the things, so AEW is a rival wrestling organization to WWE,
mm-hmm.
and seemingly to be sort of looking like it's a really good alternative for wrestling fans that maybe don't want to support WWE because of its awful history and owner, and
the connections to like killing poachers and stuff.
Yep. Yeah. Well, no, remember we found the WWF was founded by the Royals and eugenicists.
Mm. Go back to like episode 2 for that one.
Yeah, yeah. It's still my favorite conspiracy. Yeah. So this commentator's been sacked for being a full QAnon guy. That's about it, really.
Mm.
I imagine there's a lot of questionable politics going on in wrestlers, in the world of wrestling. And I remember I went to a Wrestle Rock event in Melbourne, and it was a punk rock band. I can't remember who the band was. They were really good, though. And wrestling in between.
Mm-hmm.
And the commentators of the wrestling were very problematic. Like, the one character, it was just a string of gay jokes. Which is, you know, there is, I guess, that is a big part of wrestling historically. So, but just, I guess, seeing it, this would have been 2010s, early 2010s. It was like, oh, this, you guys need to get some new gear. We're not doing this anymore. Anyway.
Next item, a lot of chatter in the conspiracy world about Boeing killing a whistleblower. Are you someone who was whistleblowing against Boeing has been found to have committed suicide, but people are not so sure.
So he's in the middle of giving evidence.
Mm.
But he's been a whistleblower for a while now.
Yeah.
He's put everything out in public. But, yeah, the trial is happening at the moment, or the whatever it is happening at the moment. So if someone turns up dead, there's some alarm bells. There was someone that was allegedly a friend of his saying that, you know, he told her that he would never commit suicide.
Mm.
And, you know, I don't know how much you can buy into that. You know, this is a random person that the media has found. I also saw talk of that he had he had some sort of PTSD and maybe some other mental health issues. Blowing just often.
Yeah. From my perspective, if I'm going to off a whistleblower, it won't be during the trial.
Yeah, you get it. It's too late. That horse has bolted, I think.
Yeah, so it didn't quite make sense to me. These Boeing people might need to tighten things up because bits keep falling off the planes.
I met a guy who works for Boeing the other day, but I wasn't really across all this. And then I read about all the stuff happening. I was like, oh, man, I really should have asked him. I probably shouldn't have asked him.
No.
Probably. I don't know someone
who works for Boeing.
If they'll fly in a Boeing.
Yeah. Well, when they get planes delivered, when they deliver planes to people, he comes with the plane. So, oh,
right.
Like a sexy lady on in a car ad.
Yeah, like it
he comes with the plane.
He bursts out of the overhead. you know, to show them how to fly it and stuff.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, you'd want to be pretty freaking confident in that job because. And I was reading about the safety issues that this whistleblower had raised, and it didn't sound good. He's been, you know, talking about the culture of safety is really bad there for decades, and now it looks like it's all becoming a real issue.
Mm. Final bit of news here, Robbo. What happens when you send cancer into space? What happens? Is it any good?
More cancer.
That's not good.
Yeah. Look.
Space cancer.
Yeah, this is from the BBC News. I just went to go to BBC News before to see if there was any royal updates, and this is one of the top stories. It's just like, man, it's just such a it reminds me of Brass Eye. I don't know if you saw.
Well, they said the pedophile into space.
Yeah, and they accidentally have kids on there or something. Yeah.
This is the one thing we didn't want to happen.
Yeah. So, whatever, just that headline just reminded me of it. And also, I'm not sure what I don't know. There's probably a reason. Anyway, Kate Middleton has just kind of dominated everything at the moment, so not a lot. I went on to InfoWars a little bit today and yesterday, and I didn't find anything interesting there either. They weren't even talking about Kate either.
Oh, you did actually bring up something interesting in the Discord, Robbo. Alex Jones, what did he say about eating ass?
Oh, yeah, he said, oh, yeah. So he posted, like, an image, like, of a photo of him and text over it, and it's like, I'll eat your leftist asses or something. Hang on, let me find the exact quote. Yeah, I'll eat your leftist ass, Alex Jones. And he's put a few filters on it, and, you know, it's like a almost like a book jacket quote or something. Yeah.
But that did lead you to ask me, why is everyone on the far right talking about cannibalism?
Yeah, so they were talking about it in terms of
Haiti.
Yeah, Haiti and immigrants as well.
I think it's refugees from Haiti that they're talking about specifically.
Right. But he's talking – so his quote that he – I think he maybe intentionally took it about out of context to get a little bit of attention.
Mm.
Because he knows how to get people looking at what he's doing. But he was saying, he's like, oh, my God, you guys are all sick. It's not what I meant. What I meant was when the America descends into civil war and we have to eat each other to survive, he will specifically eat leftists' asses.
Yeah.
Which is better, I think, somehow. But, like, you know, I've talked about in the past how much he is, like, dying to do civil war and just trying to do anything to encourage it. And turns out he'll even need an ass or two to make it happen.
Yeah. So, yeah, while that was happening, Elon Musk and people like that Ian Miles Chong again, are going on about cannibals in Haiti and how that's why we can't let any refugees in because they might start munching people.
Mm.
And it all comes from there's like a gang in Haiti who I don't know if they've even eaten anyone. I think that they might have like put out a video where they bit someone. They're like, we're fucking crazy. We're crazy. We eat yous. And the idea is to be like putting out the idea that they're crazy. The idea is not for Elon Musk to look at one of these videos and be like, we need to stop all immigration.
Mm.
Specifically the immigration of people who are fleeing from that situation where they might get munched by these crazy people.
Yeah, if you're trying to get away from the people doing the eating,
yeah,
you're on Musk's side of this argument.
Yeah, but so it turns out they're not eating people. It doesn't really happen. But you did ask me, are they trying to get it, with all of them talking about cannibalism, are they trying to get ahead of something? I was reminded that it was only a few years ago that Bolsonaro, the Brazilian president, had like the before the election, the videos came out of him talking about how he would engage in cannibalism if given the opportunity.
Mm.
So maybe Elon Musk has been at some cannibal party and it's like we need to muddy the waters on the Elon Musk cannibal search terms. And people are Googling it.
Mm.
Could be.
Yeah.
It was one of those things where it's like, this is really quite stupid. You'd have to be a little bit stupid to believe it. Or motivated by making a tiny bit of money, and it doesn't matter how racist you have to be to get it.
Mm. Mm. Every screenshot I've seen of Elon Musk that makes it out of Twitter and into other social media is increasingly worse.
Mm. And you can't even say, I don't know if you, do you know that neo-Nazi comic artist Stone Toss?
I did see a headline about him, but I don't know. I don't think I know it.
He got doxxed. In like the funniest way, which was that they were like, there was this other cartoonist that existed before Stone Toss that was very similar but less openly Nazi. Hmm. But they're like, there's a lot of similarities here. And one of the things that they both have in common is they're obsessed with circumcision and how it's, abusive, which is, that's another discussion to be had. Is it great that we're just lopping bits of kids off? Maybe not. But some of the people that talk about it too much, and this guy's one of those people.
Mm.
And they're like, this guy talks about it quite a lot. This other cartoonist talks about it a lot. We worked out who this other cartoonist was. We found other stuff that person wrote, and they talk about it a lot. And then they found all of these other connections and identified him as, I think, Hans Christian Graebner. It's like the most, if you're going to be a Nazi cartoonist, don't be named Hans. It's like, come on, dude.
It's almost an aptonym where your name's applicable to your job, almost.
But yeah, you can't even like write his name on Twitter without getting automatically pinged by the system. They'll lock your account until you delete the tweet with his name in it.
Right.
So Elon's going all out to keep the Nazis happy. I seem to recall there was a big thing about Nazis on Twitter a few years ago.
Was it?
Yeah. There was lots of them, and then they got rid of them all.
Yeah, so he came back and said he's going to bring them all back, but he also said he's going to get rid of the bots.
Mm.
And the amount of bots, or one particular thing, a phrase that bots use, is becoming a meme outside of Twitter as well.
Mm.
So, yeah, he hasn't done that either. He's made it worse.
Oh, well, good on him. Well, that's our episode.
There you go. Yeah, I look forward to hearing the news in the next couple of days and us being completely wrong. Yeah.
Yes. I'll try to get this one out quickly then. Robbo, where can they find you? If you don't want to give your business address, you can just give your personal address.
Oh, cool. you can find... No. Just here at the moment. I'm not really doing anything else.
Salty, where can they find you building dioramas?
Yes, you can get my website, artbysalt.com.
I enjoyed a Twitch stream the other day, Salto.
Thanks, mate.
I was really productive with it on in the background.
That's good. I like to hear stuff like that. Like, there's quite a few people who say they just do things while they listen to the music that I play and just me talking shit.
Mm. Oh, well, I watched a stream, Salty, and I actually watched it.
Oh,
and engaged in the chat.
You know what? I appreciate that just as much.
Yeah. Maybe a little more.
Nah, it's just as much. I'll tell you what, Luke was, while he was doing work, he was also engaging in the chat quite a lot.
I'm a freaking chat superstar.
Yeah.
When I'm in the chat.
Mm. Are you subscribed?
I think so.
Yeah.
I don't know. Not a paid one or anything.
No, right. You can find me at Sexenheimer on x.com. Yenar Pesaran on 3CR, 8:55 a.m., 4:30 Thursdays.
Also, cool. Cam, thanks for your Prime sub that doesn't actually cost you anything.
Yeah, that's fine. All right, see you later.
Did you thank the Patreon people?
Oh, yeah. And thank you to all our Patreons, especially Tammy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
Don't worry about a thing. Except if all our world leaders are alien reptilians. I said don't worry. Except maybe the fluoride in our water supply contains mind-altering drugs. Don't worry about a thing. Except whether or not Port Arthur was a false flag operation in which to disarm Australia. I said don't worry about a thing. I accept. You can definitely hear John Lennon say, I buried Paul at the end of Strawberry Fields forever. Not only did Bush do 9/11, but he also keeps the planes out in Area 51, which, let's not forget, where all the aliens are. Don't worry about a thing. Except Donald Trump is clearly a woman, and you're just blind if you can't see them. Why don't you open your eyes?